Hello everyone, a very good evening to all of you. I think there is certain issue with the internet connection. We are trying to go live still. I think it will be there in another few minutes. Just give me 1 minute. Meanwhile, I'm just trying to go live. I'm not able to. Dr. Kavita?
Yeah.
So I'm recording this session. And
okay.
In case if the live stream doesn't work out, we will upload this session later on, right?
Okay, no problem. You can share on the recording and
sure.
I will upload it. No problem.
Sure. All right. A very good evening to all the doctors, interns and students. A warm welcome to all of you from behalf of Bhargav Phytolab. My name is Ishmeet Kaur and I'm Group Product Manager at Bhargav Phytolab. With me, we have the team, product management team from Bhargav, Ms. Priyanka, Dr. Rahul Singh. And in today's iSampark webinar, we are presenting on a topic which is very, I would say, alarming for all the women because it is quite common these days, which is PCOS. And it is definitely an alarm of endocrinal axis as well. So as a speaker, we have Dr. Kavita Chandak ji. We are very happy to have once again Dr. Kavita with us. Dr. Kavita is from Nagpur and she is a BHMS MD homeopath practicing since many years. She is also the life member of LMHI and associated with Afghan Homeopathic Medical Association. She is the advisory board member in one of the journal at Istanbul. And she has also conducted many programs on health and awareness and is international speaker as well as trainer. Dr. Kavita has written and released one book as well with the title Health versus Disease at International Platform at Los Angeles. And she has published many articles in English, Hindi and Marathi in leading reputed newspapers. She is recipient of many awards. And Dr. Kavita, we are very happy to have you once again here and looking forward to your session. Before we proceed, we will first...
Thank you so much, Ishmeet.
Before we proceed, we will have a small corporate introduction. Then we will have the session by Dr. Kavita. In the end, we will have question and answers related to the session. So in case during the webinar, you have any questions, you can just mention that question in the chat window. Talking about Bhargav Phytolab, we are a 100 years old Indian multinational company serving homeopathy across the globe. We have got state-of-art technology at our manufacturing plant, which is at Bhiwadi, Rajasthan. And we are basically into research, development, manufacturing, marketing, and sales of homeopathic medicines all across the globe. We have the largest production capacity at Bhiwadi, and we produce more than 3,000 plus formulations. We have strong quality assurance, quality control, and regulatory department. And we aim for the number one contaminant homeopathy medicine manufacturer because we have got 45 air handling units which ensure zero level contamination and hence very good quality medicines for your or patients. We follow fully integrated quality starting from the very first step, which is selection of herb. We also use quality extra neutral alcohol and demineralized water, quality drug and the final quality product. In the range that we manufacture, we have mother tinctures, dilutions, biochemics, biocombinations, single remedy trituration tablets, single remedy gels, homeopathic complex tablets, homeopathic drop range, syrups, ethical tablets, ointments, dental care, external oils and gel, pellets and food supplements. And today we are proud to say that in addition to India, we are making mark globally. We are present in 34 plus countries across the globe and we do have registered offices in more than 11 countries around the world. So as we celebrate 100 years journey of serving homeopathy, the main pillars were innovation, quality, customer satisfaction and trust. We have initiated certain activities and programs for homeopathic fraternity. One such program is Aayush Sampark, which is a webinar CME initiative of Bhargav Phytolab. I believe you all are already aware about Aayush Sampark webinars. Just for your information, we also conduct Facebook live sessions. Bhargav Phytolab salutes Corona Warriors, doctors who have gone ahead and served the nation in this tough time. We salute them with these certificates. We have got an online digital platform with the name GoDoc, which is the first digital platform exclusively for homeopathic doctors. This is a platform which will enable you to consult to your patients digitally. If you are interested, you can contact us. The registration is free of cost and we are planning to go live very soon. We also have a book series with the name Beyond Practice for continuous medical updates, and we invite to publish case studies on different topics with the name Homeopathy Works Initiative. So to spread the goodness of homeopathy, in case you have any case that you want us to publish, we will publish in our journal and we will definitely share this case study with all the doctors that are there in under panel of Aayush Sampark. The sponsored brand of the day is Spondin Drops, which is for cervical spondylosis and neck and shoulder pain. Spondin Drops is the most trusted brand by homeopathic doctors. We also have got OsteoStrong tablets for bone disorders like osteoporosis, osteopenia, decalcification, and pre- and post-menopausal women. OsteoStrong tablet is available in delicious orange flavor, which makes it an excellent option for all age groups. So not taking much time, now I will request Dr. Kavita to please share her screen and take continue the session on PCOS. Thank you, Dr. Kavita.
Thank you, Ashmi. It's really nice introduction. And whenever I visit any platform or I deliver a session at any platform, I just think that I have to talk and I will not learn anything today. But see, every time I'm learning a lot. And from today's this presentation, so I learned a lot of things. I didn't know that you publish cases also. So I will send my cases to you now. You have to publish it.
That will be great, ma'am. Thank you.
So I'm sharing my screen. And so friends, today we are going to talk about PCOS. As Ashwit already told you that this is the PCOS awareness month. And when I saw this flyer of Bhargav Phytolab PCOS awareness month, and I realized that it is our duty that we should talk about PCOS, and hence this session is here for you. Ishmit, can you see my screen?
Yes, screen is visible, ma'am.
Okay. So friends, our today's session is about PCOS. First of all, thank you, Bhargav Phytolab, for giving me this opportunity to share my views here. So I always love to share a lot of cases and information with all my colleagues and junior doctors so that we can learn from each other. And this is not the just boring session that one doctor came and she just talked whatever she wanted. No, it is a paricharcha. In Hindi, we call it as a paricharcha. It means discussion. Something I will share, later on something you will share. And you are definitely free to ask any question related to session to me after the at the end of the session. So Ashwit has already given my introduction, so no need to talk about this. Friends, our today's menu is introduction of PCOS, evidence-based clinical cases of PCOS, and different homeopathic approaches to handle PCOS. See, sometimes what happens, student, later on after the session, many doctors write me a mail and they ask me, doctor, you explained this thing, but how to handle this thing? You didn't talk about particular this session or something, some other topic. See, in just 1 hour or 1.5 hour, we cannot cover everything. But what I am trying here to cover whatever is important, the prime important thing. And later on, if you have any question or query, you can ask me or you can mail me. Woman is the best creation of God. As we all know, woman is the half of the population of this planet. And till now, God has really the best created one thing, that is woman. Delicate from outside, but strong from inside. Woman is a delicate creature with strong emotions who has been created by the Almighty God to shoulder responsibility for educating society and moving towards perfection. God created woman as symbol of his own beauty and to give solace to her partner and her family. See, God must have found the woman as more responsible. That's why he gave the duty of motherhood or responsibility of motherhood to the woman only. But to balance this world, we need both Adam and Eve. To balance this world, we need to reproduce. And for this reproduction, a lady has to undergo so many changes. The first change in her life is, the first milestone is puberty. The attainment of puberty in the human female is indicated by the establishment of menses and the epoch at which she fully enters on that general development and growth which terminates being capable of bearing children. The mind too, as well as body, acquires a rapid growth, the mental capacity is enlarged, the imagination becomes more vivid, and the nervous system exhibits a heightened sensibility. You see, when we are in the puberty, we feel or we undergo a lot of hormonal changes, and these hormones are responsible to making us stand in front of the mirror half of the day. So not only physical or mental changes, but at emotional pain or at emotional plane or in your dreams, there are lot of changes. A patient become dreamy. Then second milestone is menstruation. It consists of monthly exudation from the womb and the average quantity being from 180 ml to 200 ml at each period. This is the toxicity of the body, which body just want to throw out. The duration of menstrual period varies person to person, the most common being from 4 to 5 days, and the normal is 4 and half days, as we all know. PCOS is a condition that affects a woman's hormones level during her reproductive age. Women with PCOS produce higher than normal amounts of male hormones. See, our body secretes both the thing. We have both things in our body. Like we have testosterone hormone, androgen, and even male body has all the hormones, female hormones inside there. This hormone imbalance causes them to skip menstrual periods and makes it harder for them to get pregnant. PCOS is a syndrome or group of symptoms that affects the ovaries and ovulation. Its three main features are cyst in the ovaries, high levels of male hormones, and irregular or skipped periods. In PCOS, many small fluid-filled sacs grow inside the ovaries. The word polycystic means many cysts, more than one. These sacs are actually follicles, even each containing an immature egg. The eggs never mature enough to trigger ovulation. Here we can see the normal ovary as well as the polycystic ovary. The lack of ovulation alters level of estrogen, progesterone, FSH and LH. You know friends, LH and FSH secretes from our pituitary gland and even TSH. Estrogen and progesterone levels are lower than usual, while androgen levels are higher than usual. See, the hormone factor. Women, more estrogen, less testosterone and menopause. But men has more testosterone, less estrogen and andropause. Extra male hormone disrupt the menstrual cycle. So women with PCOS get fewer periods than usual. Causes of PCOS are genetics. Study shows that PCOS runs in families. And insulin is a hormone the pancreas produces to help the body use sugar from foods for energy. Up to 70% of women with PCOS have insulin resistance, meaning that their cells can't use insulin properly. When cells can't use insulin properly, the body's demand for insulin increases. The pancreas makes more insulin to compensate. Extra insulin triggers the ovaries to produce more male hormones, like testosterone. Obesity is a major cause of insulin resistance. Both obesity and insulin resistance can increase your risk for type 2 diabetes. Few symptoms of PCOS. First is irregular period. A lack of ovulation prevents the uterine lining from shedding every month. You know, friends, our menstrual cycle has 28 days cycle. And the first 14 days, body secretes estrogen. And in the last 14 days, body secretes progesterone. Some women with PCOS gets fewer than 8 periods a year because their menses is not regular. And we usually see that the ladies or the girls who are suffering from PCOS, when they consult us, usually they have the complaint, "Oh doctor, I didn't, my menses didn't appear since last 3-4 months." And this is the first thing which hammers our brain. Yes, think about PCOS. But not only PCOS, this can be PCOS. In the beginning of my practice, I always suggested my patient to undergo for sonography just because PCOS. And we treated that only. And we always showed the difference between sonography before our treatment and after our treatment. But nowadays, in PCOS, you need to do all the blood tests, including hormonal acid. The second symptom of PCOS can be heavy bleeding. The uterine lining builds up for a longer period of time. So the periods you do get can be heavier than normal. Menorrhagia can be
Kavita?
Heavier. Yeah.
I can see so many comments related to that screen is not clear, but I can see very clear screen. Oh. So doctors, I don't know, that can be an issue at your side.
Let me do one thing. I will stop sharing and I will start sharing.
But I can see it very clear, very well actually.
Then it must be their internet issue.
Yes, yes.
Yeah. I think they can hear it because I am reading the slides for their friends. No problem. Okay. Can I continue?
Yes, you can.
Okay. Hair growth is the third symptom of PCOS. More than 70% of women with this condition grow hair on their face and body, unlikely on the unattractive places where we do not want them to grow, including on their back, belly, and even on the chest. Excess hair growth is called as hirsutism. Here we can see this patient must be suffering from PCOS because you can see the hirsutism here. Then the next symptom is acne. How it happens? When our body secretes progesterone, due to this progesterone, our skin becomes heightened and it secretes more sebum. And when this sebum come out from the skin through the pores and the bacteria get attracted towards this sebum, they convert it into the acne. Acne. Male hormones can make the skin oilier than usual and cause breakouts on areas like face, chest, and upper back. Then next symptom is weight gain. Up to 80% of women with PCOS are overweight or obese. Male pattern baldness. Hair on scalp gets thinner and fall off. It is very obvious at the age of menopause also. Because after menopause, see, our body secretes less estrogen and progesterone, which is really responsible for the hair growth. That's why hair fall is very common at menopause or after menopause. But it is not common before menopause. If it is there, then it must be associated with PCOS. Then the next symptom is headache. Hormone changes can trigger headaches in some women. Then darkening of the skin. Dark patches of skin can form in body, creases like those on the neck, in the groin, and under the breast. So whenever any patient complains to dark patches in the skin along with irregular menstruation, please, my dear friends, think about PCOS. Now let us talk about complication of PCOS. Why should we treat it? Because if we won't treat it within a correct time frame, then we have to face the complication. The important complication because of PCOS is infertility. To get pregnant, you have to ovulate. Women who don't ovulate regularly don't release as many eggs to be fertilized. PCOS is one of the leading causes of infertility in women. Second complication you may land in metabolic syndrome. Up to 80% of women with PCOS are overweight. Both obesity and PCOS increase your risk for high blood sugar, high blood pressure, low HDL, which we call as good cholesterol, and then ultimately if the good cholesterol become low, it is like a seesaw, the bad cholesterol will increase. Together, these factors are called metabolic syndrome and they increase the risk for heart disease, diabetes and stroke. Then we have the next complication, that is sleep apnea. This condition causes repeated pauses in breathing during the night, which interrupts sleep. Endometrial cancer can be the next complication. During ovulation, the uterine lining shifts. If a lady don't ovulate every month, the lining, thickened uterine lining can increase risk of endometrial cancer. Here you can see the endometrial cancer. And depression can again one of the complication. See, nowadays everybody is talking about depression. We are delivering lot of webinars regarding post-COVID depression. But only COVID or pandemic like COVID or disorders like heart attack or any emotional trauma is not responsible for depression. But even your hormonal imbalancing is the responsible factor behind depression. Both hormonal changes and symptoms like unwanted hair growth can negatively affect the emotions. Many with PCOS end up experiencing depression and anxiety. Now, how to diagnose PCOS? Three important factors. First is high androgen levels if the testosterone hormone is increased in female body. Then second is irregular menstrual cycle, like menses coming little early or too late, and cyst in the ovaries. But my clinical experience says the patient suffering from PCOS, usually there is disappearance of menses for months. I hardly observe the early menses in cases of PCOS. Then pervaginal test you can do, blood test in which we do hormonal assays. In hormonal assays, we suggest the patient to test testosterone, prolactin, progesterone, estrogen, then FSH hormone, LH hormone, and along with that, we suggest the patient to go for the serum calcium test and serum insulin test. And last is ultrasound. Now let me share a beautiful case with you. This is a case of PCOD, again one part of PCOS. A 20 years old girl visited me in October 2017 for PCOD. She had profuse, long-lasting, painful menses with frequent contraction in uterus. Sometimes menses appear only in 15-16 days. She suffered vaginal discharge for long period after menses. Her mother told, this vaginal discharge means leukorrhea. Her mother told, she does not like to mix or talk with everyone. She spends her time more with her laptop, playing games or watching movie and making her room. She can things. Nobody can touch her belongings without her permission. She is self-willed, cannot endure the slightest contradiction. Here we can see the superego of the patient. She wakes late in the morning and then sits up in the toilet for a long time. She has unsatisfied stool and sometimes has to go 2 to 3 times in morning. She cannot adjust at relative's place as she wants everything as per her comfort. She loves branded clothes, perfume and watches. She gets offended easily. She blames others easily but never accept her mistakes. She cannot say sorry. She loves perfectly prepared food with very tempting smell. She suffers cold frequently. She is sensitive to cold weather. Here you can see if the slide is clear and internet is good at your end, but I think others can see. If you can see this report, before our homeopathic treatment, when the patient consulted me, the sonography report done at 30 October 2017, referred by some other doctor, was showing finding of PCO, polycystic ovaries. And after homeopathic treatment, at 13 March 2018, means within just 5 months, the ultrasound report done, referred by me, was showing no demonstrable pathology seen in pelvis. Sorry. The rubrics considered in case were menses irregular from the chapter female genitalia, spasmodic painful menses, menses protracted, that is painful and menorrhagic, too early menses, menses leucorrhea constant chronic aggravation after menses from the same female genitalia sex chapter. Then from mind chapter, I picked one rubric, haughty. Haughty means pride. Proudy patient. See, ego is something different. Ego is your self-esteem. If you read the secretary of Carl Jung, you will understand the difference between id, ego, superego, and to be proud. So this patient is not egoistic. She was a proudy patient. And I pick one more rubric from mind chapter, that is irritability from trephals. Then from general chapters, we considered this rubric pungent desire, because she wanted every food with good representation and good smelling tasty food, that is pungent food. For chili patient, if you search the rubric in repertory in the chapter general, it will redirect you to the rubric heat, lack of heat, vital. So I picked that rubric, and from again mind chapter, I considered two things, that is censorious and fastidiousness, because she wanted everything at proper place in her room and nobody else can touch her room. So from this repertorization, many remedies came up. And I prescribed her Naxomica. Naxomica was my remedy in this case. Why? I'll explain you. But before that, I want you people to meet our Naxomica women. Because we always read that Naxomica is dominating emperor. But Naxomica has the other side too. And second question I do always face during my webinars, seminars, everywhere worldwide, that how can we prescribe Naxomica to a girl? My dear friends, Naxomica women are there, though they are rare, but still they are there. So please enjoy first this video. It will give you the idea about Naxomica, and later on I will explain why I gave Naxomica to this girl. Just enjoy this video.
But Sony, you must fall in love with your work.
Thank you, sir. But why?
What? Sir, I am Assistant Vice President of the bank.
Wow.
I can't believe it, sir. Thank you so much. Guess what?
What?
हम्म,
ये क्या है?
अरे बाबा, मुझे आज प्रमोशन मिला है.
वाव,
इंसेंटिव अवार्ड, व्हाट नॉट.
रियली तम्मी, कांग्रेचुलेशंस.
हेलो डैड, हाय.
हाय
डैड, दैट्स वन गुड न्यूज.
गुड न्यूज?
या, आई एम गोइंग टू बी अ फादर.
ओह निखिल, कांग्रेचुलेशंस.
मैं तो दादा बनूंगा.
Tanvi, if you keep up the same pace of work, you can expect another very big jump soon. Maybe in just another year. Just a... Come on, girl. Where are you?
Nothing, sir. Doctor, मैं आपसे एक बात पूछना चाहती थी.
Yeah?
Pregnancy के दौरान मुझे कितनी छुट्टी लेनी चाहिए? मतलब...
Max to max.
देखो, अब सब कुछ तुम्हारे सेहत पर डिपेंड करता है तन्वी.
यू आर इन द 12th वीक नाउ.
वर्स्ट कम वर्स्ट, इट शुड बी 6 टू 7 मंथ्स.
ओ ओके,
बाद में बात करेंगे. ओके, या बाय.
6 टू 7 मंथ्स.
तन्वी, फ्रैंकली स्पीकिंग, तुमने हमारे बैंक के लिए जो प्लान्स तैयार किए हैं उन्हें अंजाम तक पहुंचाने के लिए बैंक तुम्हारे एब्सेंस में एक दूसरा असिस्टेंट वाइस प्रेसिडेंट अपॉइंट करेगा। एंड हु नोज, दैट एग्जीक्यूटिव माइट बी मोर एफिशिएंट देन यू आर। देखो, यू गेट प्रमोशंस एज लॉन्ग एज यू आर परफॉर्मिंग। यू हैव एवरी राइट टू रेज अ फैमिली। पर कहीं ऐसा ना हो कि तुम्हारी ये ख्वाहिश तुम्हारे प्रॉमिसिंग करियर को ले डूबे। आई मीन द डिसीजन इज योर्स। आई जस्ट वांट यू टू अंडरस्टैंड द इम्प्लिकेशंस ऑफ हैविंग अ बेबी एंड ऑफ बीइंग द वाइस प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ द बैंक। यू डिजर्व बोथ, बट बोथ कैन नॉट बी अचीव्ड एट द सेम टाइम, राइट?
हे तन्वी, यू नो व्हाट? आज मेरा प्रेजेंटेशन एक्सेप्ट हो गया। वाओ, लेट्स गो आउट फॉर डिनर, बहुत मजा आएगा।
नहीं, तुम ही चले जाओ। मेरा मूड ठीक नहीं है, मैं बीमार लग रही हूँ। क्योंकि
क्योंकि क्या?
आज मैं वो अबॉर्शन करवा के आई हूँ।
क्या क्या करवा के आई हो?
अबॉर्शन?
लेकिन क्यों?
दिल की बात ना ही करो तो अच्छा है। मेरी मजबूरी, मेरा करियर।
करियर के लिए इतना बड़ा कॉम्प्रोमाइज? गॉड डैमन!
So friends, did you see here? This is our Natsumika lady, who can sacrifice her family, who can sacrifice her baby for the career. A very high ambitious lady. Just wait, I'm changing the slide. Now let me explain you about Nuts Omega women. Nuts women are rare, but they do exist. Most become careerists and excel in their chosen field, like we have Margaret Thatcher. The Nuts woman is decidedly more masculine than most and has little time for frivolities like gossiping and reading women's magazines. Like the Nuts man, she is usually very concerned with establishing her power base. Those nuts women who do not have a career often become bitter and frustrated and turn their attention to manipulating whatever power they can from their associates and family. Nuts people of both sexes are born to lead and do not do well when they are denied the chance. The homeopath who is faced with a tough career woman in the consulting room must choose between Natsumika, Ignatia and Natremure in the name. Nats is not a sentimentalist, unlike the other two. She has not become hardened as a response to emotional pain, and hence her actions tend to be less reactive than those of the Natremure and Ignatia. The tough Natrum and or Ignatia career woman tends to be very defensive when criticized. The Nuts woman may become angry when criticized, but her anger is not mixed with fear. And like her male counterpart, she will either ignore her opponent or crush him. In deciding between these three types, the homeopath may do well to inquire into the childhood personality. Here the emotionality and vulnerability of Natrum and Ignatia usually becomes apparent, in contrast to the calm determination of Nux girl. So we have the Natsumika women, and you saw the changes within 5 months. I could give the result in the case of PCOD, and this case of mine has been published by HPAC.com. This is the link for that. I'll share it later on the session. Now coming back to PCOS. First of all, let me explain you about PCOD. PCOD causes increase in the level of insulin in the body. the people having more insulin level in the blood has tendency towards obesity. Homeopathic medicine should be given to maintain the insulin level, which can reduce the weight also. Cortisonum 200, one dose when menses absent in young girls with insulin fluctuation, is advisable here. PCOD is one of the causes for frequent abortion. The lady with PCOD is more prone for uterus cancer after the age of 40 years. Second complication, as I told you about PCOS, is of course infertility. Infertility is a major issue in society and a difficult situation for a couple. Homeopathic approach to enter in cases of PCOS. To enter in case, sometimes we value the essence, sometimes the totality, that is our constitutional remedy, and sometimes it is the keynote symptom, that is PQRS. See, every patient is a new patient. Hahnemann mentioned this in aphorism 83. So approach should be different with every patient. Your mind should not be biased that this is the particular approach which I want to apply in every case. See, you cannot put your feet in Cinderella shoe. Everybody has different size of foot. So just try to understand this thing. For example, if a child has shyness in appearing people, hides himself in presence of guests, this shyness is the essence of child running throughout his behavior. The remedy can be Baraitakar. If we have this shyness along with embarrassment and weeping disposition as a totality of the particular child, then the remedy can be Pulsatilla, Ignatia and Chyna. If we have a strong keynote like desire for candies and Rasgulla, which is very intense sweet dessert, then we look the rubric desire for dentists or delicacies as a keynote. The remedy can be Argentum nitricum, Sacrum officinale or Tuberculina. See, we consider all the physical desires like desire for sweet as a physical general. But when this desire become a craving, that patient is not able to survive without sweet, and in the midnight he is getting up from the bed and searching the kitchen for to find out some sweet, and if he doesn't get any sweet, he just prefer to eat some bone vita or sugar, then we can consider this symptom as a mental rubric, because now it has become the craving. It is not just a desire. Now let us enjoy a beautiful case study of homeopathy in a hopeless case of infertility because of PCOS. In PCOS, we usually suggest the patient to get done the AMH test. AMH levels can be measured to determine how many follicles a woman has in her ovaries. AMH levels help show how many potential egg cells in a woman has left. Low levels of AMH may be related to primary ovarian insufficiency, and high levels of AMH may be due to PCOS. Women are born with their lifetime supply of eggs, and this gradually decreases in both quality and quantity with the age. Antimullerian hormone is a hormone secreted by cells in developing egg sacs. The level of AMH in a woman's blood is generally a good indicator of her ovarian result. A woman can be infertile because of low AMH. Here is the case. A 32-year-old female visited me at 19 July 2018 for deficient AMH hormone, that was just 0.01. As well, hypothyroidism. The reading was 0.06 TSH with secondary amenorrhea since 4 months. She had dark clotted menses, suppressed menses since 4 months, and ultrasound abdomen revealed bilateral small ovaries showing the premature ovarian failure. Basically, this was the case of secondary sterility. And for my surprise, her gynecologist has suggested her to adopt the child, not to think about the pregnancy, because she is not able to conceive the child as per the opinion of her gynecologist. This is her case paper, 19 July 2018. AMH was 0.01, and this is her ultrasound report done by 5th July 2018, referred by some other doctor. You can see here, bilateral small ovaries suggestive of premature ovarian failure. Now, from her life space, her husband said, she feels very disappointed after ultrasound report. Obviously, who won't feel bad? She is sad as her both ovaries are not functioning well. Her menses didn't appear since 4 months, which is making her very angry, and all the time she just sulks about it. She expects a lot from her husband and from others too. Thermally, she was a chilly patient. Honestly speaking, I was thinking sepia in this case. But when I picked the rubrics, like ovaries complaint of menses upset, menses dark clots, clotted menses, then chilly patient, and grief after losing objects, because she felt that I lost my ovaries now. As her gynecologist suggested her to adopt the child, she knew that now my ovaries are not working, I lost my organ. And that's why I picked this rubric, grief losing objects after. Brooding, constant brooding and sulking was there. Ailments from disappointment, that is very obvious. And hypothyroidism. See, hypothyroidism is a pathognomic symptom. I usually don't consider the pathognomic symptoms during my prescriptions because they are the symptoms of the disease. We have to look behind the disease. We have to search for the person. And that's why I just considered this rubric but didn't pay any importance to this rubric. Still, few remedies came up, that is Ignatia, Lyco, Belladonna, Platina, and as I was suspecting, Sepia. But then I considered one more rubric, that was anger hemorrhage from Aristo. There was suppressed menses since 4 months, which was making her very irritable. And she became angry because of this suppressed menses. See, it's very simple thing that you get irritated when menses do not appear. But there are few patients in homeopathy who do not feel anything. There is no reaction if the menses suppressed for 6 months or 7 months, doesn't matter for them. And these two patients are calcarecarb and graphitis. They do not have any mental irritation or any physical changes. But Ignatia has this change. So finally, I gave her Ignatia. And in this case, my approach was essence of the patient. See, as you can see in this image, Ignatia has high expectation and ideals, especially in romance. But not only in romance, throughout her life, she has lot of disappointments. We have the rubric ailments from disappointment, and Ignatia is the top remedy in this case. Why there is disappointment? Because until and unless you keep expectation from anybody, you won't get disappointed. If you have high expectation from everybody for everything, obviously you will get disappointed in your life somewhere. So Ignatia is the best remedy for such cases. High expectation of love is the core of Ignatia. If you are not able to fulfill her desire, then she may kick you out because anger is there in Ignatia. So, Ignatia 200, 1 aqua dose was prescribed at 19 July by considering her brooding nature, her high expectation of attention from husband, not for money, but for his quality time. And thyroidinum 30 was used as per the need of the case in further courses because already the patient was suffering from hypothyroidism, one reason. And second, thyroidinum is very good Sarcol. It always supports us in cases of PCOD whenever there is suppression of menses because of without any pathology. If there is no pathology and no major pathology in the body, still the patient is suffering from hormonal imbalance. Then we need to balance her organs and hormones. For that, we need to put some Sarcols. It is not obvious that in every case you are going to put the same Sarcol. It can change according to your case. So the report done in 12th October 2018. As you can see here, blood sugar level is normal, which was obviously normal in the last report too. But here TCH came normal. It is 3.64. Previously it was 0.06. And now her AMH has increased. It is 0.14, which was 0.01 previously. And her ultrasound report done after 7 months. This blood report we did after 3 months and the ultrasound report we did after 7 months. Because patient is not, she was not from India. She was the patient from abroad. And when she visited back to India, then I suggested her to undergo for this test. And as you can see here, no significant abnormality is detected. All the reports are normal. Ovaries are back to normal. Now, no premature bilateral ovarian failure was there. Just within 3 months, her AMH level increased from 0.01 to 0.14. And TSH level from 0.06 to 3.64 with homeopathic medication. And menses reappeared and regular. Till now, she is fine and she conceived later on. Now, I just wrote here, now who will stop her from being pregnant? But it was an old case, that's why I mentioned here. Right now, she is pregnant. So friends, here I am with some rubrics for you to, just to help you in the cases of infertility or PCOS. Just because see, various times we do not know which rubric we need to pick from the repertory. Repertory is a big subject and we really need to master it. But how will we master it? We need to read repertory every day, at least 1 or 2 pages. Read one drug of Matria Medica every day, 2 pages of Organon every day, and 2 pages of repertory every day. Random pages. Start from anywhere and end up anywhere. No problem. So here are a few rubrics to help you. We have one rubric. If there is infertility due to copious menstrual flow, then you have 14 remedies. If the menses infertility is due to copious menstrual flow along with two early menses, then we have only 2 remedies, that is phosphorus and sulfur. Then if there is infertility due to weak leucorrhea, then we have other remedies. If there is infertility with reproaching oneself, if there is any guilt in the patient's mind and the patient is reproaching himself, then we can pick 2 remedies here. One is obviously borax and the other remedy is ignatia. So few more rubrics I would like to suggest you. If there is atrophy of organs, then we have this rubric, atrophy of ovaries, one rubric, and infantilism of genital. Like if you have a case of hypoplasia of uterus, then where are you going to search it? Sometimes it is not mentioned in the repertory. Then we can consider this rubric, infantilism of genitalia. For that, we have the beneficial remedies like iodinum, conium, oveninum, baritacar, and baritamur, etc., etc. Then if there is infertility due to advancing maternal age, then only constitutional remedy you can prescribe to your patient. If infertility or PCOS is there along with the endometriosis, then we have 12 remedies and the top remedy in such cases is xanthoxylum. There is a typical pain in xanthoxylum, begin from backside of the lumbar region, travel through hip, and then it settle in your thighs. So with numbness, so you can prescribe xanthoxylum in such cases. Then if there is ovulation, tubal occlusion or hydrosalpinx, or we can say the inflammation of fallopian tubes, then we can consider these rubrics, hydrosalpingitis, oviduct inflammation or oviduct or chronic oviduct inflammation as mentioned here in the chart. And we have very good remedy, gelsimium, for this. You know friends, gelsimium even is a good remedy for rigidity of os. You can induce normal labor by giving gelsimium if there is any rigidity of the os. You do not need to land for cesarean section immediately. When I was student in my college days, we only knew gelsimium for examination funds and stage fear. But gelsimium is very good remedy and I cured a very beautiful case of bipolar depression with gelsimium, which is present there on hpathy.com and few other reputed journals also. Soon I will share it with Ishmit also. Maybe you can read in Bhargav Phytolabs journal. Then, and please consider one more remedy in such case, that is streptococcus. Because see, behind streptococcus is really responsible for this, streptococcus. So think about this remedy, streptococcus. Like we think the remedy staphylococcus for the acne. you know, a well case taken is 50% work done. Though you are not a good homeopath, but if you record the case in a proper way, you could achieve the success. So it was just a short but valuable data for you about PCOS, infertility, and atrophy of internal organs, women organs. Homeopathy is a perfect combo of traditional and modern medicine. While handling the cases of infertility with low AMH, the constitutional remedy is the better choice. But my suggestion for PCOS is, again, the constitutional remedy is the better choice. But if you get any PQRS symptom in your patient, for example, if the lady is giving lot of history to you and you have such a big file of her investigation, all types of reports done there, but if there is any characteristic symptom, like there is fear of height along with strong desire to eat sugar, and she is searching sugar to eat after midnight by getting away, you can think about the Niacin Sora, and you can prescribe either Argentum Nitricum or Sulfur in such cases. So this is what I just wanted to share with you, that with every new case, your approach should be new. It should be different. Exact approach in PCOS should be, first of all, be unprejudiced observer. Observe what is there. Don't think what I have seen in the last case. And don't compare two cases. No. Just observe what is there exactly. On the particular day, the particular patient, what is telling you is important, and your prescription should be depend only on that thing. First. Second, PCOS is a complex multi-miasmatic disorder, and hence single remedy is not sufficient. Choice of unicism or pleuricism depends on the present condition. Intercurrent sarcodes, nozodes, and anti-miasmatic must be used as per requirement, because nozodes and sarcodes work as a catalyst and they will speed up your constitutional remedies action. Approach as per individual case, because flexibility is the key. So as much as you bend yourself, as much as you bend your knee to learn something new, you will get everything good. You will get so many things from the universe. You will feel that universe is showering the knowledge on you. Now, woman is the best creation of God, as I discussed in the beginning of the session. Almighty God has created woman as symbol of his own beauty to give solace to her partner and her family, and for educating society and moving towards perfection. So can we salute the woman? Yes. So please spare your half minute to watch this beautiful video which I made for the women. Anything, your questions, just wait 1 minute. I'm trying to change this slide. Thank you so much for your patience listening. and thank you Bhargav Phytolab and Ms. Ishmit Kaur for hosting me. Dear friends, for more informative video, you can visit my channel, and this is my mail ID and website. If you have any question, you can ask me. Thank you, Ishmit.
Now, thank you so much, ma'am.
Board is yours.
Yes, yes. It was a wonderful webinar once again, ma'am. So we have question. Why do you consider menstrual symptoms while repertorization?
Why should not we consider the menstrual symptoms while repertorization? Why should not? Because women is the, see, women is, menses is the characteristic of woman. Menses is the outer part. Like, see, we have a manufacturing unit in, usually in our MIDCs. But we have showroom to display our models or our cars or our products. Understand? Like that only, uterus, breast, everything remains inside your body. Hormones remains inside your body. But menses is the display of this hormone. If you won't consider the menses, how will you prescribe your medicines? You need to consider her menses.
Okay, so dosage and potency of Nux Vomica in the first case.
Yes, because 200 potencies in gynec cases, but in this case I gave 1 mg potency because I correlated this case more at mental level. Because her mind, her behavior, it was favoring Nux Vomica, so I gave her Nux Vomica 1 mg potency, and I repeated this 1 mg potency 3-4 times, once in a month. Dry dose, not in water.
All right. Ma'am, should we start treatment with a Sarcode and Nosode or a PQRS remedy?
Yeah, see, it depends on you because patient is totally yours. When patient sits in your office, in your chamber, you are the authority person. You can learn from different pioneers, different stalwarts and different doctors. But when you are in the chamber, your patient is right just front of you. You have to take decision. So either you can start with your constitutional remedy or PQRS. But see, it is advisable that if you really have a good nosode, which is totally suitable and fit in your cases, then you should start with high potency of nosode. If there is a lot of hormonal imbalancing or the patient has consumed hormonal pills for a long time or contraceptive pills for a long time, then there is total disbalance endocrinal axis. For that, you need to remove the molecular imprints of that particular remedies from the vital energy of the patient. And for such cases, you need to imply high potency of nosodes. But it is not the rule that in every case you should start it. And you know that nosodes and sarcodes, you can use them as even as an intercurrent remedy to speed up your case.
Okay. So which other sarcode can be used?
Any sarcodes which is suitable to your case. I explained during my session, I gave thyroidinum because it was suitable to that particular case. But you can prescribe any hormones. Suppose if there is very bad hormonal imbalancing of the lady, any lady, like I have a patient from Pakistan. She is suffering from primary infertility since last 10 years. And some doctor referred this case to me. I just talked to her. She told me that I have taken a lot of contraceptive pills to extend my menses. First. Second, she underwent to the hormonal pills because her gynec gave it to her. Why? Because they just wanted to settle her menses. That 21 days hormonal pills cycle. This is also common in India too. Suppose you get such type of cases, then Meduvirenum 10 mg should be your first choice. Because you at least can settle some hormonal excess before putting your constitutional remedy. You need to clarify the vital imprint, vital energy of the patient from these molecular imprints of the wrong medications. So you can choose any nosode or any sarcode. That is up to you.
Okay, so Radhika ji has another question. Ignatia dose and repetition.
Ignatia, I gave 200. I wrote there. I gave her 200 and say within 3 months, I got the result. I gave her 200 potency once and later on she visited me after 1 month. I gave just placebo to her. Then she came at 3rd month. I gave her thyroidinum 30 and just wrote a few investigation to do. And later on we have the investigation. So in the future, I again repeated Ignatia with high potency. But these are the reports at only Ignatia 200 one dose with thyroidinum 30.
All right, ma'am. So this is wonderful. This was a wonderful webinar. Doctors are appreciating. Yes, Dr. Mahesh, we will be uploading this recorded webinar on YouTube, Bhargav Phytolab channel, and ma'am will also upload the same recording. So you can see it there.
Any questions?
No, as of now, we don't have, ma'am. No. In case of any questions, you can just tell us. You can share in the chat window. Otherwise, we will end the session. Doctors, for certificates, I've just shared a link. So I will request you all to please share the feedback in this Google form, and you shall receive the certificate directly on your email. It is Bhargav Phytolab, Bhargava Phytolab Private Limited. You can just check, you can search on YouTube, you will get the channel. And Dr. Kavita YouTube channel as well. Okay, so ma'am, we have another request for the next webinar on female remedies.
Yeah, we will definitely do it, Ishmit. Maybe at the end of October or in November.
Sure, definitely. Okay. Thank you so much, ma'am, for taking out time and coming today to share about PCOS and your, you know, experience with the cases. It was definitely a wonderful webinar. And thank you to all the doctors who joined us today. It is so good to see you all every day. So now the next webinar is scheduled for 4th of October. And another very renowned doctor, Dr. Vijay from Bangalore. So we have a question, ma'am. Ma'am, which repertory are you using?
This is synthesis 9 tracer addition, mostly. But I do refer Murphy also, Hartak also. But mainly synthesis 9 repertory, tracer addition. Okay? So all friends, bye.
Yeah, thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you everyone. Bye. See you, everyone. Bye. Bye. Thank you.
So thanks to all the doctors. Thank you, Dr. Yogini. Thank you, Dr. Uma. And I've just shared the certificate link with all of you. Link is not taking form submission. I'll just check, Dr. Sunita. I'll just check. After the webinar, I'll check. Dr. Vijay, no, I'm fine. I'm perfectly all right. Thank you so much, doctors. So we will definitely contact you soon for the next session, for the next webinar. Till then, we sign off. Thank you so much, everyone, and take care. Be safe. Thank you. I'll just check, Dr. Mukta. You can just excuse me for a minute. I'll just check right away. Responses. Okay, so now you can just check whether the certificate, whether the link is taking responses or not. Please check, one of you can check and get back. Yes, on 4th of next webinar with Dr. Vijay, he's from Bangalore, and we have a very good topic. I'll share the topic also soon in the WhatsApp group, or you can directly get in touch with me on my number 9599 69785. It's working fine. Great. So thank you, everyone. You can get the certificates from the link. It's working because just one of the doctor has just checked. I'll request you to check once again. In case if it is not working, then you can contact me on my WhatsApp number. It's working fine. Thank you, Dr. G. Thank you. All right. Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you, everyone. I'm just signing off. In case of any query, any thing that you wanted to know, you can contact me. Thank you so much.